TPM began a long time ago, actually 1995 was the initial beginning of this ministry. Mm-hmm. And it was all by providence. I didn't plan it. I didn't sit out one day and say, you know, I want to develop some kind of a worldwide ministry. I didn't have those thoughts at all. I was just a counselor. I was a pastoral counselor. But in that one session, when God showed up in that woman's life, she was a survivor of sexual abuse who had been carrying an enormous amount of emotional baggage for a lot of years, and she was in a bad place. Her doctor had diagnosed her as clinically depressed. She was on a heavy dose of constant medication. But in that session, and in my, basically I'd come to the end of myself, and I just said, Lord, I don't know what else to do here. You know, what do you want her to know? And the Lord showed up, and he spoke to her heart. She already knew the truth in her mind. She knew that it wasn't her fault. She knew that she was an innocent child. She knew that she wasn't there anymore, but yet she felt dirty and shameful. She felt somehow it was her fault, and she felt trapped and out of control, and she felt like she was going to die, and that's where the panic attacks were coming from. And I tried to convince her over and over again that here's the truth, here's the truth. You know, where are you right now? I'm sitting in your office. Are you safe now? Yes, I'm safe now. Was it your fault that that man did those things to you? Not at all. I was just 7 years old. It was an innocent child. Are you really dirty and shameful because of what he did? You know, he's the one that's dirty and shameful. I said, okay, so you know the truth. So when you think about that memory, what do you feel? And she'd begin to cry or curl up in a fetal position on the couch and say, you know, I'm trapped. I can't get away. I'm going to die. I'm dirty. I'm shameful. And I threw up my hand. I didn't know what else to do. I said, Jesus, I don't know. What do you want her to know? And he spoke to her heart. And he said, you're not there anymore. You're safe now. You're not dirty and shameful. Same thing she already knew in her intellect. But now she believed it in her heart. And instantaneously, she went from the painful emotion she was carrying to the peace of Christ. The lies, I'm trapped. I can't get away. I'm going to die. All instantaneously vanished, and the truth became resident in her heart. And now she felt safe, she felt secure, she felt that she wasn't out of control, she knew she wasn't going to die, and she felt the peace of Christ. Well, that was the beginning of what became a worldwide ministry that I didn't plan. It wasn't, you know, and at that point, I didn't have any thought about worldwide ministry. I just thought God had done an incredible miracle in front of me. I did not have the thought that this was something that was going to happen again and again and again. I just thought it was for this moment and this occasion, and I was rejoicing. Went home, told Sharon how glorious it was. Never had the thought that God was going to do this again. And I absolutely did not have the thought that this is what God is doing every day in the life of every believer who will submit to him to receive. I did not see that one coming. I did not have the understanding that Ed Smith needs the same thing she was receiving. Because what happened in that moment was simply the refining of her faith and the renewing of her mind. And the outcome of mind renewal is transformation. And that's where the word in our ministry name, Transformation Prayer Ministry, comes from. It's because God is transforming our lives into the image of Christ. When we choose to position ourselves to receive the truth that he has for us in our hearts, when he persuades our heart of the truth, we will be transformed by that truth. Now, a whole lot of us, I'm afraid, invest much of our lives and our time and energy in trying to conform our behavior to the truth. Mm-hmm. And how's that working for you? You know, we'd like to see it's working great. You know, I'm doing the best I can to live and look like Jesus. I got my What Would Jesus Do bracelet on to remind me to do the right thing. And I'm proceeding. I'm moving forward in this. Yeah, right. Let's get honest with ourselves and recognize is that apart from Christ, we do nothing of eternal value. He is the one who is transforming us. He is the one that refines our faith, purifies our belief. He is the one that renews our mind, and he is the one that transforms our lives. He's calling us to rest in his work.